الرحمن الرحيم، والحمد لله رب العالمين، بارئ الخلائق أجمعين، باعث الأنبياء والمرسلين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين، حبيب إله العالمين، المصطفى بالقاسم محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا. ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين إلى قيام يوم الدين. من لم يكن علوياً حين تنسبه فما له من قديم الدهر مفتخر. والله لما برى خلقا وأتقنه صفاكم واصطفاكم أيها البشر، وأنتم الملأ الأعلى وعندكم علم الكتاب وما جاءت به السور، مطهرون نقيات ثيابهم تجري الصلاة، عليهم أينما ذكروا. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وقرآنه الحميد وقوله الحق: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. صدق الله العلي العظيم. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. On the 17th of Rabi'ul Awwal, which coincides this coming Tuesday, inshallah, there are two major celebrations. The first is the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, Khatamul Anbiya'i Muhammad. And the second is the birth of his great grandson, Al-Imam Ja'far ibn Muhammad al-Sadiq, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. And therefore, inshallah, if Allah gives us tawfiq tonight, we will discuss briefly about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayh. And tomorrow, we'll dedicate it for Al-Imam al-Sadiq, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are included in the dua of Al-Imam al-Sadiq salamullahi alayh, when he says, أحيو أمرنا رحم الله من أحيا أمرنا. Revive our traditions, may Allah have mercy. This is the dua of Imam al-Sadiq salamullahi alayh. May Allah have mercy, rahmah, on those who revive our traditions. So if Imam al-Sadiq prays for rahmah, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who are included in the dua and the rahmah of al-Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Bi barakat al-salati ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali. Tonight, if Allah gives us tawfiq, we will mention, inshallah, five ayat of the Quran to demonstrate the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. There is a riwayah attributed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. Ya Ali, ما عرف الله إلا أنا وأنت. No one recognizes Allah other than you and I. That's it. وما عرفني إلا الله وأنت. And no one recognizes me but Allah and you. وما عرفك إلا الله وأنا. And no one recognizes you but Allah and me. This hadith, honestly, if I were to spend a whole lecture on this hadith alone, we probably would not suffice it. Can you imagine the depth of this hadith? Nobody recognizes Allah, no one, according to the riwayah, other than you and I, Ya Ali. يعني other than Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi and Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam, there is no way of recognizing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us to recognize Allah. And other than Amir al-Mu'mineen and Allah, there is no way for us to recognize Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And other than Rasulullah and Allah, there is no way for us to recognize Amir al-Mu'mineen salamullahi alayhi. This makes us understand a little bit the hadith, أَنَا مَدِينَةُ الْعِلْمِ وَعَلِيٌ بَابُهَا. I am the city of knowledge and Ali is the gate. فَمَنْ أَرَادَ الْمَدِينَةَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ فَلْيَأْتِهَا مِنْ بَابِهَا. Whomever wants knowledge and wisdom, let him come from the gate. يعني if you want to get to the city, if you want to get to نبوه and understand something about نبوه, you have to go through إمامه. Imama gets you through Nubuwa, and Nubuwa gets you to Tawheedullah Azza wa Jal. That's how we can go through this. Tonight, if Allah gives us tawfiq, we'll take a look at some of the ayat of the Quran to have some understanding about the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran calls prophets, several prophets, by their names when He calls them. For example, Allah says, Ya Adam, uskun anta wa zawjuka al-jannah. O Adam, Ya Adam, Ya un-nida. يعني when you call someone, you say, Ya fulan. O Adam, you and your wife live in the garden. Allah refers to Dawood. Ya Dawood, inni ja'iluka fil ardi khalifa. O Dawood, I am making you a representative on earth. The father of the prophets, Ibrahim, alayhi wa ala nabiyyina wa alihi salam, Abu al-Anbiya. And the second best prophet after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. Allah still calls him by his name. Ya Ibrahim, qad saddaqta ru'ya. But when it comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, although his name is mentioned in the Quran, the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi is mentioned. Quiz. How many times is the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi mentioned in the Quran? MashaAllah. How many times? The name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, how many times? Zero? Zero? Habibi, there is a surah called Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. How could it be zero? Okay, so at least now you know one, at least. Three times, four times, going once, twice, four times. Four is correct. Four is correct. Three times mentioned as Muhammad and once as Ahmad. Sallu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in Surah Ali Imran, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. The second one is in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Third, in Surah Al-Fath. In Surah Al-Fath, مُحَمَّدٌ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَالَّذِينَ مَعَهُ أشداء على الكفار وحماء بينهم. Did we say four times? Sorry, that's not the right answer. Five times. The fourth one is in Surah Al-Ahzab. وما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم. That's four. Four as Muhammad. And the last one, الصف. الصف. ومبشرا برسول يأتي من بعدي اسمه أحمد. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. So four times as Muhammad, once as Ahmed. صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. Although his name is mentioned in the Quran, as I mentioned, but never does the Prophet Allah calls him يا محمد مثلا. صلوا على محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. Allah always says يا أيها النبي, يا أيها الرسول, يا أيها المزمل, يا أيها المدثر, but never calls him by his name. This is an indication out of the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Other prophets are called by their names, but the prophet is not mentioned by his name. When Allah calls him, that demonstrates his azamah, one aspect of his greatness. That's one. Two, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talks about Isa ibn Maryam in the Quran, pay attention to this. In Surah Ali Imran, Allah says, إِذْ قَالَتِ الْمَلَائِكَةِ Ayah 45, when the angel said, يَا مَرْيَمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ إِسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ. Okay. So here Allah is giving the news to Maryam that she is going to be having a child, Isa alayhi salam. Then later in ayah number 48, listen to this ayah. Allah says, وَيُعَلِّمُهُ يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يُعَلِّمْ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ. Allah teaches عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمْ. What? وَيُعَلِّمُهُ الكتابة والحكمة والتوراة والإنجيل. Did you hear that ayah? I repeat it one more time. ويعلمه الكتابة والحكمة والتوراة والإنجيل. يعني Allah is teaching him. Allah will be teaching him. Teaching who? عيسى عليه السلام. Teaching him what? الكتاب الحكمة التوراة والإنجيل. Okay, so far so good. What does Allah say about our Prophet in Surah الجمعة? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هو الذي بعث في الأميين رسولا منهم يتلو عليهم آياته ويزكيهم ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة. Allah says about our Prophet, he is the one who teaches. Mu Allah is teaching him only. He teaches. There, about Isa, what did Allah say? Allah is teaching him al-kitab wal-hikmah. Correct? Here, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi teaches al-kitab wal-hikmah. وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. He teaches Quraysh or these people kitab and hikmah. You see the difference? One is being taught by Allah. One not only is taught, he's above and beyond that level. Now he's at the level of teaching. Teaching al-kitab wal-hikmah. That shows you the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. That's a second example from the Quran. Third example from the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam two of his own attributes, صفاتullah Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nur refers to himself as Ra'ufun Rahim. Allah refers to himself in Surah An-Nur, Ra'ufun Rahim, compassionate and merciful. These two attributes, Allah gives them to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. In Surah At-Tawbah, ayah 128, the second to last ayah, the one we recited at the beginning. لَقَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولٌ مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ عَزِيزٌ عَلَيْهِ مَا عَنِدْتُمْ حَرِيصٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَتْ رَؤُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. two attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gives to himself in Surah An-Nur in the Quran, he gives them to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi in Surah At-Tawbah as well. Compassionate and merciful. And indeed, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is all compassionate, all merciful. The rahmah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, the compassionate nature of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is magnificent. The teachings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is great. It is narrated after the death of Abu Talib alayhi salam. Abu Talib was not an ordinary man, by the way. We have riwayat. Abdul Muttalib, the grandfather of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Abdul Muttalib كان من الأوصياء. The grandfather of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He was one of the أوصياء. And his wasi was Abu Talib, the wasi of Abdul Muttalib. There is a riwaya from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. The riwaya goes along the lines that every two parents who carried me from Adam, يعني up to Adam, Allah chose the best of a father and mother to carry me from my father and mother all the way to Adam, the best. This suggests that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, remember the lineage of Rasulullah goes to which prophet? You guys should know this. And then who? Ismail. Okay. From Ismail, do we know there are any prophets? Not that we know of. What about Ishaq? What about Ishaq? Come on, guys, you know. Don't scare me here. Ishaq was a prophet of Allah himself. What about his children? Yaqub. Yes, Yaqub was a prophet of Allah. What about the son of Yaqub? Yusuf, a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These are the children of Israel. Yaqub huwa Israelullah. Yaqub is Israel. Israelullah means the one whom dedicated to himself to Allah, so Allah chose him. That's Israelullah. And hence, children of Israel, يعني شو? يعني the children of Yaqub. So many prophets who are the descendants of Yaqub. In fact, lots of them. So you have Ayyub, is from Bani Israel. Dawood from Bani Israel. Musa from Bani Israel. Isa from Bani Israel, and so on and so forth. All these prophets are from the children of Israel. While these prophets are there from Ishaq, Ismail's descendants were also coming down. Are you with me so far? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi, in his riwayah, he says, my fathers and my mothers are the best of Allah's creation at their time. What does that tell us? It means the fathers and the mothers of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, who lived at the time of these prophets of Anbiya Bani Israel, these parents of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, at that time were better than these prophets of Bani Israel. Did you understand that? And that shows the azama of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, an aspect of his greatness. Among them is Abdul Muttalib. Abdul Muttalib. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi was born, Abdul Muttalib came and said, this is going to be a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knew. When he was born, Amina bint Wahab, his mother, she saw the angels descending down in her house and the nur of the angels and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi illuminating her house. So after his birth, the mother of Imam Ali salamullahi alayhi, what is her name? What is the name of the mother of Imam Ali alayhi salam? Fatima bint Asad. Okay, good, mashallah, good. I'm impressed, you guys are good, mashallah. Fatima bint Asad went to congratulate Amina bint Wahab on the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi, the little boy. Now remember, our Prophet was born orphan. His father died before he was born. So she went to congratulate her. Amina عليها السلام started describing to Fatima بنت أسد the miracles and the wonders she saw when she delivered Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله, how the angels came down, how the nur illuminated her house, and so on and so forth. She described to her. So then Fatima بنت أسد سلام الله عليها said to Amina, said, do you give me the permission to carry this little boy to my husband Abu Talib so I show him? She said, yes, take him. So she took the baby prophet صلى الله عليه وآله to Abu Talib and she told him, ya Abu Talib, you know, this is your nephew Muhammad صلى الله عليه محمد وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد. So Abu Talib was very pleased to see him, of course. Then Fatima was telling Abu Talib the wonders that Amina told her about the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, what she had seen. Abu Talib smiled. He told her, أمهليني سبتاً. السبت في اللغة يعني 30 سنة. He said, give me 30 years. And you will have, ya Fatima, you will have a child who is equivalent to him, except he will not be a prophet. Allahu salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Who is he referring to? Amir al-Mu'mineen, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. Yani Abu Talib, salamullahi alayka ya Abu Talib. And they questioned whether he was a Muslim or not a Muslim. Abu Talib knew 30 years earlier that 30 years later he will have a son equivalent to this boy, except not in the Nubuwah. He will not be equal to him in Nubuwah. And he will come 30 years later. And indeed, 30 years later, Allah blessed him with Amir al-Mu'mineen, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. And Fatima bint Asad also saw the wonders at the wilada of Amir al-Mu'mineen, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi. This is what whom we're talking about. When we say Abdul Muttalib, when we say Amina and Abdullah and Abu Talib and Fatima bint Asad, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhim ajma'een, we're talking about some noble, virtuous people. When Abu Talib died, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, the Prophet left Mecca. He went to At-Ta'if. He went to At-Ta'if initially. In At-Ta'if, unfortunately, people did not appreciate his presence. And they started stoning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam as he was calling them and inviting them to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So then he started going away from the people as they were stoning him. He found a garden, a farm. So he entered into the farm. The owners of the farm, they saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi. They recognized him. And so they felt bad for him. So they told their slave, they had a slave farmer. They said to him, take some of the grapes that we have in the farm and give it to Muhammad, sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Sallallahu ala Muhammad. Allahu salli ala Muhammad. The slave took the grapes, he put them into the plate, and he went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi and put the grapes in front of him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi picked up one of the grapes and he said, Bismillah. This slave, he told him, the people of this land don't say this. Where are you from? He said, Bismillah. In the name of Allah. He said, where are you from? He said, I'm from Mecca. Where are you from? The Prophet asked him. He said, أنا من نينوى. I'm from نينوى. نينوى is Iraq. He said, بلد أخي يونس ابن متى. He says, that's the area of my brother, يونس ابن متى. Indeed, Prophet يونس is buried there. He said, you know about يونس ابن متى? He said, nobody in here knows of who is Yunus. How do you know about him? He said, أنا رسول الله. أنا محمد بن عبد الله. صلوا على محمد وعلى محمد. اللهم صل على محمد. I am a prophet of Allah. I am a messenger of Allah. This is my name. I know this. Yunus was a prophet of Allah, and I am a prophet of Allah. So these words really pierced the heart of the slave who was a Christian. And his name was Addas. Addas. Addas then fell onto the feet of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, started kissing them. And he said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa annaka Rasulullah. Allahum salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. These two owners of the farm, the two owners, they said, Afsada alayna abdana. He said, he ruined our slave for us. Khalas, now our slave has turned against us. He believed in him. So they told him, get out of our farm. Get out. You know, you came for 2 minutes and mashallah, now one person is already a Muslim. You know. So they kicked him out of Al-Ta'if, out of the farm, and he went back to Mecca. Question, the thing is, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi traveled all the way to Al-Ta'if. And he went through that stoning so that he becomes a reason for one person, this Addas, to become a Muslim. You see, brothers and sisters, how important is the religion of Islam? Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi went through so much, stoning and all that pain and the travel from Mecca to Al-Ta'if, back again to Mecca, so that one person becomes a Muslim. But that is how important it is. So we should not take our religion lightly, friends. If this is how much difficulty our Prophet endured so that one person becomes a Muslim, it tells you how important it is to hold on to this religion. And that's why, friends, I want you guys to understand how important this religion is, how great it is, how great our Prophet is, so that we can hold on to it. Never doubt the greatness of Islam. At the same time, uphold the values of Islam, especially when we talk about the Salat and the Siyam and all those, that's very important, but the way you deal with people. The way you deal with people is extremely important. The way you deal with your parents, the way you deal with your children, the way you deal with your siblings, the way you deal with your spouses, this is extremely important. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. I was sent to perfect and complete the perfection of manners. يعني the way you deal with one another. So this is extremely important. So you see, this is the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. All right, so we go back. First example of the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam from the Quran was what? You guys forgot already. You already forgot, mashallah, mashallah. Sorry? He's, yes, the Prophet, Allah does not call him by his name. Rather, he calls him Ya Ayyuha Nabi, Ya Ayyuha Rasul. Correct. Second one was what? That yes, not only did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teach him like Isa alayhi salam, Allah taught him Kitab and Hikmah. Rasulullah teaches Kitab and Hikmah. Third was what? He is Ra'ufun Rahim. Two attributes of Rasulullah, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he gives to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Bil mu'mineen ra'ufun rahim. So these are three. Number four, my dear brothers and sisters, when we take a look at the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and try to think about this one. Allah says, you all memorize Surah Al-Fatiha, inshallah. Right. What is the second ayah of Surah Al-Fatiha? You're thinking about it. You shouldn't. Why are you thinking about it? Ar-Rahman? No. The first ayah is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, friends, in Surah Al-Fatiha. I got you this time. The first ayah in Surah Al-Fatiha is the Basmala, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So what's the second ayah? Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الحمد لله رب العالمين. What does رب العالمين mean? What does رب العالمين mean? The Lord of the worlds. The Lord of the worlds. We're not talking about one world. Worlds. When we talk about worlds in dunya, we can understand there are several worlds. For example, those of you who study biology, you know there is like the animal kingdom, correct? Then there is the plant kingdom, for example, right? So these are different kingdoms, different worlds in our world. Plus, are we the only galaxy in the universe? No. I was reading an article the other day on the website of NASA. You can look it up yourself. NASA's website says that scientists, as of today, have discovered 200 billion galaxies. Galaxies, not planets or stars. Galaxies. 200 billion galaxies that they have discovered. So imagine, subhanAllah, how vast is our universe. This all is in the materialistic sense. All this is in the materialistic sense. We still have a world or worlds before our world. We have عالم الذر, عالم الأرواح, عالم الأست, عالم الأنوار. All this is before us, before this عالم. Then after this dunya, we have عالم البرزخ, we have عالم الآخرة. You see all these worlds? Allah says, الحمد لله رب العالمين. Praise be to the Lord of the worlds, all these worlds. And then what does he say about our Prophet? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. يعني, we did not send you but as a mercy to the worlds. What does that mean? Wherever the lordship of Allah extends, the mercy of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi also extends. Can we even imagine that? Think about that one. رب العالمين رحمة للعالمين. يعني the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is a rahma in our world, to the animal kingdom, to the plant kingdom, to all the other kingdoms. He's a rahma to the universes and the galaxies. He's a rahma in the worlds before our world. عالم الأنوار وعالم الألاست وعالم الذر وعالم الأرواح عالم البرزخ عالم. You see this? Subhanallah. That is beyond even our comprehension. How does all this? There is a riwayah from Imam al-Sadiq salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayh. On the day of judgment, ma min ahadin aw ma min shay'in fi yawm al-qiyamah illa wa yahtaju ila shafa'ati rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ma min ahad, no one on the day of judgment. Everyone, Imam al-Sadiq, and according to this riwayah, everyone will need the intercession, the shafa'ah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. When he says everyone, it means also the prophets. يعني حتى إبراهيم, أبو الأنبياء, عليه وعلى نبينا وآله السلام. All the prophets will need the shafa'ah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This shows you the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. And this is number four. You see, subhanAllah, he is beyond our comprehension. Fifth ayah in the Quran, which I think many of you memorize it. In Surah Al-Qalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَىٰ what? خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Indeed, you have the greatest of manners. Now, this ayah is referring to one aspect of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi and refers to that one aspect as azim, great. خلق أو خلق عظيم, صح? This ayah does not mention the other things, the other aspects of Rasulullah. يعني if one aspect of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وآله is عظيم, imagine what about if you put all the other aspects together. خلق عظيم. The ayah does not talk about علم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله. It does not talk about حكمة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله. Remember, he teaches علم. يعلمهم الكتابة والحكمة. يعني he has so much knowledge. It doesn't mention the knowledge of Rasulullah. It doesn't mention the leadership aspect of Rasulullah. It doesn't mention the worshipping aspect, ibadat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It mentions one aspect. One aspect of Rasulullah is azim. So imagine if you put his knowledge and his ilm and his wisdom and you put his, for example, ibadat. If you put all this together, then what do you have? If one aspect of him is azim, خلق خلق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله is عظيم. What about everything else? When you have the whole رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله, can you imagine? You see, brothers and sisters, this is our prophet. And that's why the hadith goes, ما عرفني إلا الله وأنت. Nobody recognizes me but Allah and you. يعني who would have even perceived all this? We can't perceive all this. But it demonstrates to us the greatness of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. My brothers and sisters, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi is so great, and it is a pride for us to have such a great leader as our Prophet. When he came sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he transformed the lives of people. He transformed the lives of people. If you take a look at Arabia, before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, did they have a civilization? Nothing. For centuries, they were living like a flat line. Until the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi came. All of a sudden, they started ruling. Within 100 years, the Muslims started ruling 2/3 of the world, producing so much knowledge. يعني if you take a look at the graph, timeline is all flat, 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 until the Prophet comes sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. When he comes, all of a sudden, knowledge starts shooting up. So it means he sparked it, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. He introduced it. He revolutionized Arabia. That's why there is a British writer by the name of Thomas Carlyle. Back in the 1840s, he gave a series of lectures titled The Heroes. In one of his lectures, he calls the hero is the Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Where he says that a man who came to Arabia who were a bunch of nomads. Nomads, يعني were illiterate people, ordinary people, shepherds. All of a sudden, within 100 years from his time, they started ruling 2/3 of the world. This man is a hero. How he managed to revolutionize and change these people. Now, one important aspect, brothers and sisters, about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, is turning the people of Arabia into human beings. And that's important. Human beings. One day, there was a man in Medina. He had two daughters. These daughters were fasting. Their father went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam because they had asked their father to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi a question about their fast. So the father went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi to ask him a question about the fast of his daughters, related to their fast. The father came to ask Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi told him, your daughters are not fasting. So the father became embarrassed. His daughters have sent him to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi to ask him a question about their fast or related to their fast, and now the Prophet is telling the father they're not even fasting. So the father became embarrassed. He came back to the daughters. He said, how could you embarrass me in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi? He said, how? What did we do? He said, I asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi about your question, and he told me that you're not fasting. So why did you embarrass me? If you're not fasting, why did you tell me to go tell the Prophet? He said, father, we have not eaten anything. We are fasting. So the father went back to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, ya Rasulullah, my daughters are saying they're fasting. They have not eaten anything. He said, call your daughters over. So he called them over. They came. He said, you two are fasting? They said, yes. He said, didn't you two today talk about so-and-so and backbite, dughiba, backbite? While you're fasting, they were fasting, but they had backbited somebody else. Here, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alayhi wanted to educate. This is what they call a teaching moment, a prophetic teaching moment. He tells them, bring out the piece of meat that you've eaten. They said, we did not eat any meat. We did not eat anything. He said, cough it out. Indeed, they coughed out and a piece of meat came out. Both of them, they were shocked. They said, ya Rasulullah, we did not eat any meat. Father, we did not eat anything. We don't know where did this piece of meat come from. He told them, this backbiting that you did, the ghiba that you did, it converted. Now, this is by the blessing of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Okay. Doesn't happen to an ordinary person. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ. What does ghiba? Allah describes ghiba as what? Does one of you like to eat the dead flesh of his brother? Rather, you hate it. يعني وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. When someone backbites, gossiping. And how often do we have that happening in our communities, mashallah? Mashallah. So-and-so said, so-and-so did. So-and-so bought, so-and-so sold. قاعدين هذا. الشكل. This is what we talk about. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wanted to teach them. He said to them, this, the Prophet showed them by the qudra of Allah, by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this backbiting that they did got transformed into a dead flesh of meat, wal-iyadu billah, that they coughed out. Here is a teaching moment. يعني, not only the fast itself is important. Siyam is important, of course. We fast, inshallah. But the spirit of the fast is also important. What is the spirit of the fast? That you uphold the teachings. يعني you uphold the hijab. You uphold, for example, the backbiting and the gossiping. Stay away from it. You uphold the good manners and the good akhlaq. Brothers and sisters, this is an important lesson we leave with today. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wanted to transform the people, not just into people who worship Allah and that's it. Pray, fast, give sadaqah. All this is very important. It's extremely important. But at the same time, uphold the values of the salat and the siyam into your life, implement it into your life. That's what he wanted, to transform people into human beings. So the way we deal with one another is extremely important. Make sure never fool against someone else, lie to someone else to the best of your ability. Respecting your parents to the best of your ability. And when we make a mistake, as I told you in the past, we do istighfar. We ask Allah for forgiveness and we try to go back to doing what's right, inshallah. This is important. So now, my friends, I know that month of October is coming up. And at the end of October, there is usually something that happens. Mashallah, mashallah. I don't think you were as excited about the Prophet's wilada as you are about this. So when your parents tell you, for example, I don't want you to go, then listen to the parents. Listen to the parents. Okay. We're not saying going is haram. But unless your parents tell you not to, then it becomes an issue. Then it becomes a problem. Okay. But instead, if you can celebrate the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, which is coming up on Tuesday, inshallah, with candy, with all bunch of goodies in the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That has a lot more ajr than dressing up as a pumpkin or whatever it is that people dress up as these days and going out. Okay? فيعني, try to be always in a respectful manner to your religion and to your parents. So if the parents say no, خلاص, it's the end of discussion. It's no. And if they don't say no, then that's something that you want to have a conversation with your children about. But the wulada of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is coming up. Celebrate it. You get so much more ajr and thawab and khair and barakah, inshallah. And inshallah, you get included in the rahmah of Imam al-Sadiq. Rahimallahu man ahya amrana. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those, inshallah, who follow the path of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih and gain from the wealth of knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih and attain the shafa'ah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alih in dunya, in the qabr, and in the akhirah.